The Kanto region is a region that has been around longer than any other. It is 25 years old, technically about 30 years old if you count the time that the original Pokemon games were in development, so you'd think that we would know pretty much everything there is to know about it, and that all of its mysteries would have been solved. Well, that is unfortunately very wrong, as Kanto still has some secrets hiding within its borders, and it's got one in particular concerning a cut location that is very intriguing, and it's exactly what we're going to be getting into today, which is all made possible by today's wonderful sponsor, UCast Studios, who I run my Pokemon podcast with, and Moorpark College.
Moving forward together at Moorpark College this fall means more choices than ever. Enroll now and return to campus and the classroom. Take hybrid classes that are half in class and half online. Experience high flex classes with students in the room while others watch live online. Or take fully online classes. Enroll now for fall. Find out more at moorparkcollege.edu/together.
So, what's this about a cut secret Kanto location, you might be asking? Well, this is something that I have actually touched on in a couple videos before, but I only ever scratched the surface of it. According to Cut Content website, The Cutting Room Floor, within the data of Pokemon Red and Blue, there is an unused map that is listed, and it is listed just after all the other town and city maps in the game. It is also designated as a location that the player would be able to fly to, and no wild Pokemon are specified to be able to appear in the area. All of this suggests that this map was most likely that of a town or city of some kind that was scrapped from the games, but this is all we know concretely. The games don't specify where this possible town was intended to be located, but there is another piece of supplemental evidence that can help us determine where that likely is. On an early map of Kanto that comes from the days of when the series was still known as Capsule Monsters, so very early on in Pokemon's development, we can see that Kanto looks virtually identical to the way it does in the final games, with just one noticeable difference. In the center of the map, there is a square, which seems to be designating a town of some kind as it matches all the other towns that are also represented by squares on this map, and it is labeled with a C. Given we know that we've likely got a missing town in the data of Red and Blue, and we've got one town-shaped icon on this map that doesn't appear in the final games, we can surmise that these two are likely one and the same. But there are some very unique things about this town on the map that make this a little more complicated than just that. First off, it is one of the only locations that is labeled with a letter instead of a number, with the only other exception being Saffron City, which is marked with a T. It's also not located where anything else is actually located in the final games, and most strangely, it's not physically connected to any other part of the map. You could say that maybe this is because it's an island, but Cinnabar Island is clearly connected to the rest of the map, so that can't be it. So what in the world is going on with this location? What was it planned for? Why isn't it connected to anything else? Well, as puzzling as this may seem, I do have a possible explanation to offer. Sitting right next to this mysterious location is Celadon City, and that's rather interesting because there is one thing about Celadon City that has always struck me as rather odd. As many know by now, all of the towns in Kanto are named after colors, and this includes Celadon City. However, despite being named after a shade of green, Celadon is known as the Rainbow City, and its gym even gives out the rainbow badge. So with a region whose towns are all named after colors, wouldn't you think that a place with the rainbow designation would be a lot more important, like maybe an endgame sort of location, than what really is nothing more than just a mid-game city? Part of this connection does come from Celadon City's Japanese name, Tamamushi City, being named after the jewel beetle or Tamamushi beetle, as it is green with a rainbow-like iridescence. However, the point that a rainbow city being in the middle of the game instead of the end of the game like it seems it should be does seem kind of weird, and that actually got me thinking. What if this unknown town or location is actually where the Indigo Plateau used to be? The Indigo Plateau would make a heck of a lot more sense with the rainbow branding than Celadon, and maybe Celadon just ended up with it as like a carryover after this location was removed, since the two do sit so close together? We do see on this map that the final location for the Indigo Plateau is still present, but this scrapped location is consistent with a lot of factors that would be fitting of a Pokémon League. There's the potential rainbow element, which makes sense. There's the fact that it sits in the center of the region with everything else you'd have to go to get there surrounding it. And the fact that nothing is connected to it could be explained by this as well. If it's the last location in the game, it would naturally be completely inaccessible until you had all the gym badges, and maybe it was only able to be reached by flying as a result of this, as we know, thanks to the in-game data, that it could be flied to. All of this is pretty consistent, so it's at least worth a thought, but we don't really have smoking gun type of evidence quite yet, do we? At least, we don't right now. Now, full disclosure, this final piece of evidence I have to show you should sort of be taken in a lighthearted manner. I'm not saying this proves beyond all reasonable doubt that my theory is right due to the context of it, but it is uncannily consistent with everything we've talked about. If you were around during the original age of Pokemania when Pokemon Red and Blue first came out, then you may have heard about the Pokemon Master Trainer board game. This is a board game that is based on Pokemon Red and Blue that initially came out in 1997 in Japan, so just a year after the game's release. It's a pretty faithful board game adaptation of the Kanto games. You go around and catch Pokemon, build a team, and fight to be the first one to the Indigo Plateau and become champion. Now, here's the kicker. On the board for this board game, the Indigo Plateau is placed exactly where this scrapped location from the early Kanto map is placed, right below Celadon City. Like I said, full disclosure, this is just a board game, but they could have put the Pokemon League literally anywhere on the board. They could have just as easily put it where it actually is in the game, since everything else is in its proper location. So, why here? I don't doubt that when making this game, Tomy, the original creators, had access to some kind of documents or official material from Game Freak and Nintendo for reference, and maybe something in there, like this mysterious unknown location, led them to put the Indigo Plateau in this location. Like I said, it's not quite a literal smoking gun, but it is pretty eyebrow-raising at the very least. So what do you guys think about this idea? Could the Indigo Plateau have originally been in the center of the region and maybe named the Rainbow Plateau or something to that effect? Honestly, the rainbow thing is kind of a toss-up, but I think there is some solid evidence on the Indigo Plateau part. Let me know all your thoughts about this in the comments below, and be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed. It really helps out. With that said, I'll be back with another video very soon, and until then, as always, I love you all, thanks for watching, and I will smell you guys later.